Hello and welcome back to MSPO 2024 with Defence 24. We are at the Hanwha Group stand and we are talking to Mr. Sunwook Park, formerly of the Republic of Korea Navy, member of the Hanwha Ocean Group. Hello.
Hello, Jin Dae-woo. I'm Sunwook Park, the Vice President of Hanwha Ocean and especially in charge of Oruka project. Nice to meet you, and especially I really appreciate you inviting me to Defence 24, the most popular channel in Poland. Thank you.
Thank you for having us and thank you for taking your time to answer our questions. Now, you're a former submariner, so you know a lot what it takes to command a submarine like this. So can you speak, please, before we ask any questions about the submarine itself, to your experience as a submarine commander?
Yes, I retired a couple of months ago, so I served my Navy more than 30 years. Before that, I served submarine more than 20 years. So my career was a submarine commanding officer. After that, the submarine squadron commander, and my last job was submarine education and training commander.
This puts you in an excellent position to answer some of our questions. So, this is a very special submarine in many respects. So, what is it that makes it so special from your point of view as a former submarine commander?
Based on my experience, I bought a 209 class and 214 class, for instance, KSS-1 and KSS-2. Actually, both of the ships are much focused on surface warfare. The KSS-2 is a little advanced, but it's a little restrictions in my the country's requirement. Actually, my country, South Korea, is surrounded by East Sea and West Sea, and also very powerful neighbors, China and Russia. From the north, we have standing threat. That's why we need more deterrence options to defend my country and also deterrence our potential threats.
I'm glad you brought up the Yellow Sea because in many respects, that sea is actually quite similar to the Baltic Sea, which is the primary area of concern of the Polish Navy, obviously. Now, can you speak to the similarity of these two seas from your perspective as a submarine commander?
Yeah, definitely. So far, I have so many questions about the Baltic Sea. I understand your concerns about Baltic Sea, the shallow water, but actually, Baltic Sea is a little deeper than the Korean West Sea. In terms of the maritime environment, the West Sea's mean depth is 43 meters and the maximum 152. However, Baltic Sea's mean depth is 54, maximum is around 460. In terms of the geopolitical situations, we operated in West Sea, but not only by ourselves, also the China. China's nuclear submarine operated in West Sea. And based on my submarine commanding experiences, I have exercised with U.S. submarines in West Sea. As you know, both Chinese and U.S. submarines are pretty much bigger than Kilo class, even pretty much bigger than KS-3. So in that point, you don't need to worry about the shallow water depths in West Sea. And also, the KS-3 is highly advanced and a very automated system, so she can control the depths and the course by very easy way using the automated system. I can say that.
So what you're saying is that despite its large size, this can safely operate in the Baltic Sea or seas like it.
So as I mentioned, she's very advanced system in terms of automated system, what is called the depth autopilot and also course autopilot and controlled by what is called IPMS. Integrated monitoring systems, all those systems are monitored, operated by one or two men through the trim system and compensation system. So even the shallow water, she can maintain specific water depths very stably.
One last question I have. This is a very highly advanced project, but it's made almost entirely in Korea. How much input does the Korean industry have, and does this system depend on imports of parts and components from other countries than Korea?
Well, before we introduced KSS-3 Batch 2, we have operated KSS-1 and KSS-2, as I mentioned it, but it's a little short of the capabilities requirement for Hwang Navy. So, as I mentioned, North Korea developed nuclear capabilities, long-range missiles, and China and Russia. So we need the specific deterrence capabilities. so she can provide strong deterrence and defense defending capabilities to my country.
So it is being continuously updated, it's in production, and it's highly advanced and it's available for export. Is that how you would sum it up?
Well, currently the three submarines now operating by the South Korean Navy from the 2021 without any problems, any accidents. So I can say it is very proven, and we can provide it only 60 years past delivery. And this is based on cutting edge high technology, so to speak, lithium-ion batteries and fuel cell batteries, the AIP. All she has the high technology sonar sensors, including the conformal and also the TAS system. And she has the link system to communicate headquarters the real times. So everything's very well equipped for Polish Navy's requirement.
Excellent, Sunwoo Park. Thank you very much, sir, for the introduction to the KSS-3.
Thank you.